I never normally upload on a Wednesday, but today I have a bonus video of tips from 2017 that you might have missed. These clips are from older videos, so the audio quality might not be as good as 2018, but the content is still important and useful nonetheless. Also, sponsoring today's video is bookmark.com. Bookmark is an awesome cutting-edge service where you simply answer a few questions and you're going to receive a WordPress quality website completed in under 2 minutes. So if you don't want to spend a fortune on a high-end website, check out bookmark.com linked in the description below for further details and information. Global Colors is a great addition to the Illustrator software, and it allows you to edit the same color throughout an entire design with ease. Here's how it works. You will first want to open up your swatch window. Let's say I intend to make a vector design in Illustrator CC with these colors. I simply need to select all of them, like so, and then add the new color group here. Make sure to select the global color option and press OK. You will notice this white symbol in the bottom right corner of the box. This tells you that now it's in fact a global color. If I quickly duplicate the pink circle here, you will see when I double click the pink swatch and edit it, all of the circles will change accordingly. Make sure to click the preview option. So let's review that quickly one more time. Here I have a design that I crudely created, and you can double click the swatch after making the global color, and then edit it as you see fit with the preview option selected. The next Illustrator top time saving tip relates to selecting objects in a group section. This tip cassette here is made up of various different shapes that are all grouped together. If I select it with the standard selection tool, it will select everything at once. Instead of going up to object and ungroup, I can simply press A on my keyboard to access the direct selection tool, and then select individual objects, even though they're all grouped together. It should be noted that if you click within the object with the direct selection tool, you can move it around. But if you click an anchor point, you can edit the shape and the anchor instead. With the next tip in this list of Illustrator top tips for saving time, we're going to cut through these shapes perfectly. If I take the eraser tool in Illustrator, I can quickly cut through these shapes, but even with the steadiest hand in the entire world, it's not going to be perfect. Instead, hold down the shift key and then click and drag. Even if you drag your cursor over the artboard, the line will remain straight. You can then ungroup the selection and remove the unwanted areas of your design. I've told you guys before about pressing the Tab key on your keyboard to remove panels in Illustrator on your screen so you can view your artwork. But if you press Command F or Control F on a PC, you will gain a better view, but then if you press it again, you're going to have the most clearest view possible by going full screen mode in Illustrator. This allows you to see your work from afar in a very clean manner, much like an artist would step back from their easel to admire their work. So you press it one more time to return back to normal. The first way to use Illustrator vector brushes is going to be a very neat way to add to a design such as this. This vector brush technique is also good for specific logo designs and so much more. You need to open up the brush window here, or you can simply press F5 on your keyboard. You will see a collection of brushes here, which we can add to, but also you can drag and drop the brushes into the trash can in the bottom right corner to delete them. For our vector brush today, we're going to create a perfect square with the rectangle tool by holding down shift. You then need to lock the square down in place, as we're going to use it as a guide. Press P to locate the pen tool and then draw along the guide all the way around the square but not fully. and then come in a little bit into the middle somewhat like so. Select off of the pen tool path with V, then drag the shape away and unlock everything. You can now delete the square because we don't need it anymore. Increase the stroke weight and then with direct selection tool, you can drag the line at the top and the middle across a little bit. We're going to make a pattern border with this design by using vector brushes in Illustrator, so make sure you have a decent size and stroke weight for your design. With the shape selected, go to the brush window and in the top right corner, click New Brush, and then we need to use Pattern Brush. You're going to be met with a whole host of options, but today we're going to use the Stretch to Fit and also the Tints option. You can rename your brush to something relevant and then click OK. You can then double click your brush in the window to adjust it at any stage. So for example, I made a typo on this brush name, which I can change quickly. So in what way can we use this vector brush? To make a border on this design, we simply need to take the rectangle tool and make a rectangle across the entire canvas. With it highlighted, simply click your brush and the pattern will be placed around the border. I've chosen the wrong setting. I want to use tints only so I can adjust the color as I want to. We can then adjust the position, the size, and the stroke of the border.
For those of you familiar with Photoshop, you might recognize this tool for selecting huge areas of Photoshop artwork. In Illustrator, it works slightly differently, however. If we have a design with many different segments in Adobe Illustrator, you may want to select parts of it that have the same color, the same stroke, and so on. If I want to select blocks with the same color, I can hold down Shift and try to guess which ones are the same by clicking them individually. If we take the magic wand tool here, the shortcut being Y on your keyboard, we can speed up the process and make it more accurate. You will need to open up the magic wand window right here. We want to select objects according to the fill color. With a tolerance of 20, if I select a block, it will select many different colors similar to it, but not exactly the same. If I then put the tolerance down to 1 and select a block, it's going to select only that specific color. The Satori bonus tip of the day relates to saving time when using the pen tool or drawing any shapes with Illustrator. If your design is symmetrical, why not just draw half of the design, group everything together with Ctrl or Command G, and then use the reflect tool? If you remember this technique, you will save a lot of time in your graphic design work for sure.